We thought 2023 was a big year in tech, but 2024 is the year that these technologies will literally change your life. 2023, when we look back on the impact specifically around AI, we can instantly see that it was warming up to what's to come in 2024. Yes, 2023 feels like there were some really big tech advancements, but it was really setting the foundation as to what is gonna happen this year. We are going to go through what are some of the top technologies that are going to change your life, yes, you, me, everyone's lives this year. Understanding what technologies will have a huge impact in our life does a few things. One, it keeps us ahead of the curve. You know where to put your focus when it comes to learning new things, reading up or educating yourself on new things. And the other thing as well is it keeps your, what is it, your pulse? Keeps you having a pulse? I'm not sure the saying, but it keeps you on the in and ahead of what's going on. Now is more important than ever to be aware of what technologies are up and coming. I mean, it's moving so quickly, that's the least we can do. And we are gonna do this all in a very short amount of time. Let's get into it. Oh, and if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, leave down in the comments other videos you want me to make. And that's really what I make these videos on, is what you want to see. If you haven't joined Takeoff already, I link down below Takeoff. It is a place where you can come learn at your own pace. However, you wanna spend an hour learning, you wanna spend a few minutes a day learning from real industry experts. These are people who have worked for years within the tech industry. They have faced so many challenges that we all face throughout our careers. They also dive into specific roles, technologies. It's amazing. So go join it today. Let's get into it. All right, listen. You knew I had to include where the future of AI is going in 2024, mainly because in 2024, we will be unable to escape AI. I know some of you, I've read comments from some of you saying, I don't ever want to program using the help of AI. I don't want to learn with AI. The reality is though, if you do not start embracing these technologies, you will fall behind. AI, generative AI, is now being implemented in almost all businesses, almost all online sectors, that if you aren't willing to start using some of these tools or exploring with them, I really believe you will fall behind. People who are using these technologies to learn will learn at a quicker rate, quicker pace, and also be able to build, whether it be technically build apps, build websites, or so many other things. Now, on the flip side with AI, do you know what's coming up in 2024? In the United States specifically is the 2024 election. Now, why do I bring this up? Well, because even from past elections, we've already started to see the use of AI to spread disinformation. And now with AI getting scarily good, you can't even tell the difference between a photo that was generated with AI to a photo that was taken by a human. This is going to have a huge impact and play in the 2024 election. Tons of fake news will be spread, potentially, of course. And the one thing that is key to all this is big tech is really going to have to start putting their foot down and having regulations in place to potentially protect this AI space, meaning have something in place where you can see that this image is generated by AI, different labels, things like that. Now, my one worry with that is, will it happen quick enough? Meaning, even if that technology is in place, it still takes a bit of time for the system to typically realize that this is AI generated, meaning it can still spread a lot of disinformation. I don't know, I'm really curious to how this will play out, but this, regardless of how it plays out, is a technology that will impact our lives in 2024. Another piece of technology I think will have a huge impact on our lives in 2024 is actually the metaverse. And I know some of you are probably like, Tiff, that is so 2 or 3 years ago, what are you even talking about? But here is why I think this year will be the year of the metaverse, if it's going to happen, which I think it might have the potential to. Hear me out. The reason for this is because, well, Apple's now in the game. And it seems like whenever Apple gets in the game with new technologies, not saying this is new technology, but kind of takes an interest in something, they really push it forward. With the announcement of the Apple Vision Pro back in 2023, we are expected to see it release this coming year. And I think with the release of that, it's going to be a really big telltale sign if the metaverse is going to become a thing, if you will. How will it be used? I really envision as, you know, remote workers, I'm a remote worker working from home, want to have a closer or are feeling like they want to have a closer connection to their coworkers, friends, family. I can see it being used in those kind of settings, you know, where it's this virtual kind of office space for meetings, different things like that. It's still kind of hard for me to wrap my head around, and maybe we just need to throw up our hats for the metaverse and realize it's not a thing. But my prediction is in 2024, if it's going to become something, it will be this year because of the backings of Apple behind it. Another area that even if you would have told me a few years ago would really have an impact on our lives in 2024 or technology per se is physical convergence. So what exactly do I mean? You can see, even looking back to 2023, our physical and digital worlds are becoming closer and closer intertwined. I mean, nowadays it is more valuable to have more friends, or that's what we perceive as value, I should say, to have friends online or followers online than in person. We care more about our online image than we do about our image in real life, which is kind of a weird feeling. And honestly, even saying it is kind of depressing when I think about it. And I'm trying to be an optimist in this, but it will continue our physical and digital worlds to become closer and closer. And what I think will happen is we will see this emergence of digital twins. We've spoken about digital twins for quite a while in theory, seen them play out, especially in different industries, where digital twins essentially are a replica of yourself, but in the digital world. We see this kind of happening already, even with different kind of smart watches or technologies. For example, for those of us who wear our Apple watches or smart watches, and it takes a replica of our health. So it knows about our heart health, it knows about our sleep patterns, all of that will continue to become more advanced, that we have this separate version of ourselves, but it's in digital form. And as our digital form or our digital self per se has more data about ourselves, especially our, you know, health patterns, our sleep patterns, all of that stuff, it will be able, experts, scientists will be able to take that data and then make more informed decisions on different discoveries when it comes to medicine, when it comes to really taking the next step in helping society. That's the positive outlook on it anyways. Another area in tech that will have a huge impact on your life this year is around data. And I know we've been talking about data for a long time now. Is data still sexy like it used to be? Well, one thing it is for sure is continuing to be more and more valuable to companies. Yes, you heard that right. We thought it couldn't get any more valuable. It can. And we've seen this over and over again, especially I noticed in 2023. Have you ever noticed, or maybe this is a Canadian and US thing, but have you noticed that everywhere you go now, they are starting to collect data on you? If you input your information, you get to skip the line in airports. If you sign up for this card, you get major savings at grocery stores. This is nothing new, but now everywhere you go has this put in place. Why do they put this in place? Is it because they really care about you? No, absolutely not. They put this in place so they can gather more information, more data about you, and in turn help their business. I believe in 2024, we will see a lot more of this kind of data collection, almost to the point where we just think it's the norm. Now, that doesn't mean it's necessarily a bad thing, but I do think it's something that will have huge impacts on our lives in 2024 and something to really be aware of. Where are you giving your data, or who are you giving your data to? And what information, what are they doing with that data? These are all questions we really, as a society, need to start asking more of versus just blindly handing it over to get that discount. I don't know. You all are all technologists. You really know what's going on in the tech world as well. Do you agree with this one? Do you think data will have a huge impact on our lives this coming year? I really believe it's kind of going to be the tipping point. All right, those are some of the top technologies that will impact our lives in 2024. For good, for bad, maybe somewhere in the middle. I think a little bit of both. At the end of the day, being aware of what's coming up and what is trending is so key though to staying ahead, not only in your career, but also too, I believe, in your personal life, seeing what trends are coming up. And even I hope through this video, you gained some examples, you know, with the US election or with how data is being collected, that these technologies impact our everyday lives. And if we are able to educate ourselves on them and be more aware of them, it's kind of better for everyone. All right, make sure to hit that subscribe button again. Thank you all for watching. Leave in the comments what other videos you want, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.